the balance beam. Remember the Olympics? I watched, along with the rest of the world, as the beautiful little gymnasts on the balance beam flipped and skipped on a long suede-covered board 4 feet off the ground. It looked to me as narrow as a thread. No matter how high they jumped or twirled or threw themselves in the air, they had to land back on that beam. It was a marvel of balance. I would think that in order to do that, those young girls had to manage their fear of falling. If they did fall off, they were in trouble. They had to stay focused entirely in the moment. They couldn't let their minds wander or dwell on the consequences. Bear with me, please, for I'm having an outbreak of metaphor. It seems to me that we elders are on a balance beam also. We do our level best to stay on it until the dismount. It takes courage not to dwell on what happens if we fall off that straight and narrow path, like ill health, the loss of our marbles, injury, despair, and so on down the disaster list. The fun stuff, as the devil may call it. We have our own balancing act to do. Stay on and try not to dwell on the consequences. We are all crossing the same beam, so to speak, but each in our own way. Some of us manage to push down that fear and enjoy the dance as we go along. Maybe even try a trick or two. Some of us journey across as cautiously and carefully as possible, inching along, trying to manage our fear of falling. But we all have to dismount. I'm still working the metaphor, seeing our last years as a balancing act. We have managed to stay on that beam for as long as possible, but we know we cannot stay up there forever. And maybe we don't want to. The aim, as we gymnasts say, is to stick the dismount, that is, to come to a perfect landing without stumbling, without messing up the end of what has been a good show. We have worked hard and long on that tricky beam and have done our best. We deserve to stick the dismount. I wish for us all a perfect landing.